Hello everyone and welcome to the Megabuild project. Today we are at Greentop Nursery and we are going to be building a kitchen and crew quarters and a patio area enclosure thing. So we're back. So while I'm fiddling with this thing trying to line it up, because that's a problem, you know, when you get to this part of the build where you've got a lot of other stuff around, you have to make sure that you put everything down right the first time. Because if you don't, you have to disassemble the whole thing to move it. You can't just pick it up because it's surrounded by crap. So first things first, I want to thank everyone who sent kind thoughts about the hurricane issue. We got off pretty light, got about 9 inches of rain. It got a little exciting with the wind at some point, and the power went out, I don't know, 3, 4, 5, 6 times. No lasting damage. They didn't have to call the insurance company, no flooding or whatever. And then after that, like on Monday, Tuesday, I would have released this earlier, but Houston is in really bad shape. And so I've been spending a couple hours every day after work down at the food bank, down at the distribution center, you know, packing boxes, filling trucks, doing whatever, you know, they need a couple of hands to do. So I was pretty tired. So I'm back trying to do this thing here. And then I'm sure if you're a longtime subscriber or you're a new one or you just drop by, you'll notice that I managed to hit 1,000 subscribers. I am flattered and pleased and shocked and sort of, I want to thank you all very much for that. It's when I started this, I had no clue anybody would even like these things, but it turns out apparently some of you do. So thank you. I will endeavor to earn that praise and that attention. So today, this thing here is going to be, I'm going to try and build tall. I'm going to deliberately try and build tall because ever since Sheklador dogged me about not building things 3 stories high, I've been like, I don't even know how the hell to do it because I build low and scrappy. That's my thing, you know? I don't know. Just when it gets to a certain height, I have a problem visualizing how it would make sense to do anything else. So yeah, I got to move some stuff out of the way. So we're gonna do, like I said, kitchen and patio and whatever. So while this is going on, watch me struggle with what I'm gonna use and how to get pieces to fit and redoing stuff. Wait till we get to the ladder. There's a spot coming up where I'm trying to put a ladder and it will not snap. I can't figure out why it doesn't snap, but we'll see that in a minute. So lately I've been thinking about, I've been playing Skyrim, you know, and I've been thinking about ways that if I have the ability to improve the settlement building experience, you know, what would I want? How would I do it? What kind of things, if I could create a settlement building thing, what would I want it to be able to do? And I don't know. It's a weird kind of thought, you know. I mean, how would you? I mean, yeah, of course it's console, so you're limited with the UI and you're limited with the controller, and there's a bunch of stuff that, you know, whatever. But I mean, the first thing I would want to do, I think, is make it easier, give console players, and it will give everybody, but give us a way to, I'm thinking here, I'm like, what do I want to do here? Now I've got this big box, I need a roof. Let's just start throwing things at it and see what happens. So I would really like a way to make it easy for the player to modify the menus, you know, the menu at the bottom of the screen. What goes where? And what categories you have. I mean, how would you do that? I mean, you really couldn't do it in the game. It would be a real total pain in the ass because you'd have to reserve a button to, you know, select it and go modify UI or whatever. But it would be nice if there were, like, I don't know, an XML or something that you could do outside of the game that would be easy to make a mod out of, you know, that you could just make your own mod, upload it, whatever. Because right now the CK is, you know, I mean, it's good, but if you're a newbie like me, it's pretty intimidating. There's a lot to it, and So it would be nice if there were an easy way to modify the categories, you know, or make subcategories, you know. I don't know. Because, like, for instance, like elevators and marble tracks, I mean, I barely use those things, so I would just love to get them out of the menus. A bunch of stuff that, like, I'll never use. Or maybe have modules that you would, like when you went into build mode, it would spawn them and you could just pick them up. Like say, I want to use this wood now. Just pick up that module and it would make them, whatever, that's probably dumb. But what I would really like is a way to nudge things. this, I mean, in the PC, it's not as problematic as it is with the console. Because the console will have two sticks, right? And they're analog and they have an accelerator on them. So it's really hard to get fine tuning. It's really hard to get specific precision placement with the controller. So I was thinking about how the hell would I do it if I could bolt it onto this system? And I was thinking, I don't think there's anything I use the right shoulder button for in building. You know, I use the left one, right, for the up and down, the left trigger and whatever. And the left button and the left stick to move it up and down vertically. But it's like, there's no use for the right button in build mode. So it would be neat, it would be really cool, is if you had a piece selected and you just tap the right button and it would go into nudge mode, where every time you move the sticks, it would go like a pixel. You could still move it horizontally, vertically. You could still do the A and move it around, or the X and move it around. You could still do, you know, A and L, A in the left trigger, or what is it, L2 on, I don't know. But yeah, moving it horizontally, you could still do all those functions with that toggle. And then when you're done, you could just, you know, take it out. That would be pretty friggin' amazing. So yeah, those are the two things I think that I would like to see the most, is the ability to nudge things. And of course, as a side note, it would be cool as hell. Well, you know, while I'm dreaming and getting a unicorn and a pony and whatever, it would be neat that if you did, you know, click the right button to go into nudge mode, it would turn off collision at the same time. So you wouldn't need the rug glitch anymore. It would be like a weird version of Place Anywhere, kinda, sorta. I don't know. I don't even know if that makes any damn sense. But it would be cool if there was some way to place things with much more precision on a console because of the clumsiness of the controllers. So, but what I'd really love to see, one of the things I really wish I had more power to do without, say, the Conquest mod, is that, you know, you're stuck with whatever the game gives you for areas, unless you have a mod. But wouldn't it be neat if, when you started, the game had like two or three different settlement areas? Like, I don't know, Boston Airport would be one because of Brotherhood, and then Sanctuary, of course, would be one. And then you'd have, I don't know, just those two. Let's say two or three. There would be two or three specific things, right? And then for the rest of the time, the game would just give you 20 workbenches. You could put them anywhere you want, you know? And when you put it, what you could do is you could put it down, right? And it would have a set area around it. Hexagonal, let it be square, rectangular, whatever. But it would be a standard shape, a standard size, and it would be centered on the workbench, wherever you put it, right? And, you know, normal rules apply when you're building on that workbench in that zone. Okay, cool. So that way you could put your thing down, and by putting a workbench down and enclosing an area, it would turn off monster spawns. It would just eliminate all the spawn points, all the random stuff. It would, you know, get the game out of the way so you could build there. But the cool thing about that is, if you were feeling really ballsy, you could put like five or six different workbenches adjacent to each other, make a gigantic sprawling. So for the people who like having huge build areas, you could, if you wanted to, you could just place three or four or five or six different workbenches, you know, subject to the limits of the horsepower of whatever system you're on. And, you know, you could always take it up and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, the mechanics would be, if you built a bunch of stuff and you just took the workbench out, it would just scrap everything and stick all the crap in the workbench. So you could just, you know, keep moving around. But that way you could have sort of this like weird nomadic existence where you're like, okay, I'm just going to build one settlement and I'm just going to cart it around everywhere I go. Or, yeah, okay, instead of scrapping things, it could just, you know, put everything back in the build menu. You know, like when you store something, the storage would stay attached to that workbench. So that you could place it, you could be a nomad. You could be a Commonwealth nomad running around and building your house. And that way it would be kind of cool because it would be interesting because you could pick, you know, what kind of terrain you wanted. You could pick if you wanted to be near a water source. You could have more of a thing, because it doesn't make sense that you're, you know, kind of chained to these workbenches, chained to these areas. Because, I mean, the workbenches weren't here when, you know, they built these things pre-war, so somebody must have put it down at some point. So why couldn't that somebody be you? So yeah, pie in the sky. I'd love to have 20 or 30 workbenches and I could just put them wherever the hell I wanted to. And it would be kind of neat. Yeah, here I'm testing the floors, make sure they'll go back in, because I want to put those little surfaces on them. I don't like the concrete bottoms, but now we're gonna sit here and watch this thing go by. While I try and pick a floor that I think looks good. I think I saw it plaster at some point, but yeah, trying to figure out. See, I didn't think to drop climb on the ladder because when it gets too far, when it gets too close to the ground, it, you know, turns green and I can't see the pattern. So I gotta keep it up in the air. So yeah, that's what's going on here. That's my wish list for settlement building. And of course, having all the assets in the game in the build menus to start with, cool. Or maybe not all of them. You know, maybe you would have to unlock them. You would have to go to a certain clearing area or whatever and pick up a tool bag or something, or a shipping crate or whatever. Or hell, blueprints like they do with the automatron, you know. You could pick up blueprints for various buildings and structures and stuff like that. Which, I mean, kind of would make sense, you know, that you could learn how to do things. Or, you know, you could put actual libraries in here and pick up specific books, or, I don't know, maybe after you built X number of buildings, it would just automatically give you more. But then that's just dumb, because then you start grinding like in an MMOG. You're just like, oh, I need to build 30 buildings to get to the next level of building. And that's just boring. So yeah, I'm going to stick with the plaster here and do this. So, yeah, I didn't really plan anything. I'm so exhausted from all that extra work. And now, of course, now there's a gas shortage down here because people are panicky. They hear a rumor, oh my God, there's going to be a shortage. So what do? They go out and buy as much gas as they can, creating a shortage. It's like, well, you know, if y'all just would have calmed down, it would have been okay. It would have been whatever. So, yeah. So one thing I am going to do on this video as well is I'm just going to build, because doing this, building this thing took way too long, in my opinion. I spent too long fiddling with things and trying to get things to work, because I'm not really familiar with these particular pieces, at least as much as I'd like to be. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to build the shell of the, I'm trying to think, what am I going to do with this? Where's things going to fit? Where am I going to put the kitchen stuff? Where am I going to put this and that? When I did go around looking at kitchens, I went to Shamrock Tap House. That was an interesting one, kind of big. Shamrock Tap House, for a bar, has a pretty big kitchen. I mean, they got, what, 4 stoves in there, man. That's a lot of stuff. Yeah, the railings won't go on. the thing's on, so here we go, build order. But this thing the floor covering clips right into the railing. So I went to Shamrock Tap House, and it's a big kitchen, big industrial kitchen. But one thing about it is, why didn't the railing come with it? That's weird. Okay, well, I'll group select it, but it won't snap if you group select it, dude. So, well, I'll just try and take it off. No, it won't fit in there. So we'll slide this back a little bit. Will it snap? Nope. A little more. Now it snap. Yep. Okay. Because now I know, you see, now I know the floor will slide into the railing, so I can just move it back or just leave it there. Whatever. It doesn't really matter. So anywho, went to Shamrock Tap House, and they had a pretty standard loadout for kitchens. Like, it's got all the elements of every kitchen. It's got a storage room, which is mostly the 4 shelf metal shelves. It has stoves, sinks, prep areas, refrigerators, but it's got a lot of stuff. For some reason, Shamrock Tap House is very large. So after that, I was like, okay, that's decent, but I'm going to be building a smaller thing, so I need to see a smaller one. So then after that, I went to Cambridge. Because Cambridge has that diner, and there's that little open-air cafeteria right down by there by the police station. So I was like, looking at those. And when I went in, I was like, oh, well, that's interesting. It's the same stuff. It's the storage room with the metal shelves and the prep area in the back. Okay, here's the ladder. I have no idea why this ladder would not snap to this piece. It makes no sense. There's nothing obstructing it. There's nothing in the way. It's not too high or too low. I mean, the floor surface, I mean, when you look back, it turns green if I push it down. So I'm like, okay, good. Maybe it can't go through that bottom floor. Maybe that's the problem. I don't know. But I spent entirely too much time fiddling with this damn thing. So, okay, Shuckle Door, does this count as 3 stories? Because that's the third story. We're on the third story right. Does it count? Because if this counts, then I did it. I finally built a 3-story building. And to me, it looks completely blocky and huge, but maybe y'all like it. I don't know. But it suits. It fits, you know, because it ends up sleeping 5 people. So I went there and I looked at the cafeteria. And the cafeteria had a neat little, like a kiosk with the cash register. You know, it used those little round fancy counters. and a little desk thing in the bottom, and it had a little, it was just, it was cute. It was really compact. It was cute. It was cool. Now, of course, now look at this. It snaps to the ladder, but the ladder won't snap to it. This is the kind of things about building that baffles the crap out of me. Why is this not working? So here I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna, and he's like, yeah, it ain't gonna snap, dude. It's not gonna snap. Stop. So here I punt. I figured out an alternate solution. Scrap it. Get the small stairs, because they snap to each other. Look at that. It snaps. It snaps. If you know why that ladder wouldn't snap, man, leave me a note in the comments, because I'm still baffled by this. I'm like, why the hell wouldn't that ladder snap? It just doesn't make any damn sense. Because the two half ladders snap, and they're the same size as one, but I don't know. So here's a loft. This loft came from the idea I saw. There's a little warehouse by the Boston Airport, kind of in the water. I think it's over by the airport. It might be over there by Andrew Station. But there's like a warehouse that has this kind of little loft above it. Most of them do, really, but I remembered it. I'm like, huh, cool. So you know, now with the half ladders, I got half ladders on the brain, so we're going to stick these in here and do one of my patented corner staircases. It just saves me a little space. And now I've got that little thing sticking out. I'm like, what do I want to do with this? Do I want to make a... So I do make a little cubby hole, little storage area under the roof line there. And of course, I can't snap this in because there's no wall. Those triangular pieces only snap the walls. And since I'm not sure if a full wall will fit in here, let's go ahead and just use the half wall, just to give me something I can snap to. Stick that there, look at that, it does it fine. And then we'll get our glass, put it in there, snap. Scrap that, put everything back. But yeah, we're big on the disassembly and reassembly thing here. I don't know why that wall sticks to the floor like that, but it's cool that it does. It's kind of neat. Been experimenting with other pieces. It's getting dark, and I'm just now starting to figure out that it's getting dark. So this, the skeleton of this, is pretty much done. I got this balcony here, and I'm trying to think what the hell am I going to put there. Excuse me. Yeah, we'll just stick that there. That's fine. That's what the stink from the kitchen doesn't... Well, and then I put a railing here, because duh. Maybe I'll make that... maybe I'll change that railing later. But maybe not. Who knows? So we're going to go out here, and then we're going to go sleep, eat and drink, and now it's daytime again. So now we're going to build the open area patio enclosure, which is basically a combination of junk fences. Yeah, I'm looking at it going, how do I want to do this? Where? Because I'm too close to the build limit to put stuff on the outside there. That was probably a mistake, but that's okay. I've got a little area behind there. I've got, you know, it's out of the way. It's obviously a kitchen. I need some stairs. And here we go. The first time I've ever used these things, and these, for whatever reason, these things worked fantastic. I am really, really happy with how well these things clip. And here we are lining it up. I'm looking at the sides, looking at the center, going, okay, how do I center this? Well, I will just put that center pin on the center of the floor, and that will be the middle. And then I just line it up, get it to turn green, drop it. Boop. There we go. And there's our approach, which actually suits this building fairly well, to be honest with you. It suits. I was really surprised. I'm going to need some pillars in there. I do put some pillars in there later. So what I'm going to do after this, I'm going to try, this is why it took so long to do this, because I had to record it like three different times because the power kept going out, and then one time it came back and corrupted my game and I lost like, I don't know, an hour and a half. I'm like, thanks, man, thank you. So what I did is I tried something new today. I'm building the framework, you know, laying out the sketch part of it. And then off camera, I went through and I adjusted it, right? Fix the things that weren't working, change things I didn't really like, that didn't seem right. Because what I like to do is build this, right? Record it, build it, go to sleep. Wake up, look at it again fresh tomorrow and go, okay, what isn't working here? Because when I'm in the midst of building it, I'm thinking building, building, building. I'm not thinking about how it fits into the whole. And I kind of have to see it new, quote new, to get an idea of how it fits. And this... Yeah, see, it's tall, and that's good, but it's a little bit too tall, I think. I don't really like that. Looking at it going, no, it's too tall. We need to lower that a little bit, I think, before I start building anything else. I'm looking at the range. I'm looking at it going, do I really want to build high walls around the whole thing? Probably not. So let's go pull it back out. But, of course, everything turns red. Oops. Let's go and grab my rug and get it back out. So in this one here, I built the framework, built the thing, and then I off camera, I went back in, figured things out, adjusted stuff, furnished it, trimmed it up, And then at the end of this video, we're going to tour what this framework looks like now. It's not decorated, of course, but it's furnished. It's got people working in it. It's got, you know, it's got a, there's a sense of a place to it instead of just a bunch of structures. So yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do about 1,000 subscribers. Everybody's like, oh dude, you got to do something. I'm like, why? I mean, don't get me wrong. I am really grateful, but it's like the subscriber count isn't why I started this. Why I do it. I do it because I just wanted to share this stuff, you know? So, I guess what I'll do is I'll tell you what, let's do this. If you're still paying attention to my ramblings and it's not too obnoxious, let's try this. I will, in the comments below, I want you to suggest a settlement that I have not built out before, okay, that you have not seen me make a video of before. At this point, it's gonna be like, well, I mean, really built up. Not like the little shacks I built at Warwick and not like the little shack I built at Coastal Cottage and some survival, that didn't really count. I mean like a settlement. And I will try and build a settlement there on the settlements and survival character. So let's see, that would encompass, it would be the Slog. It would be Coastal Cottage, Kingsport Lighthouse. Croup Manor is a settlement. I'm not gonna build there again because, oh my God, I don't like Croup Manor. I really haven't built at Warwick, you know? I haven't built at Spectacle Island. I haven't built, I guess Murkwater would count. Murkwater would definitely count. Somerville? Is Somerville? We'll put Somerville on the list. And okay, so here's Scrap Bob being a pain in the ass because it doesn't want to behave. The ground doesn't want to behave here. It won't do it. And I spend way too long trying to figure out why it won't go. See, but it does go here, and it's like, why don't it go with this piece? I don't know. Where were we? Egret Tours. I did build for the challenge there, but I didn't really build a settlement there. So we could do Egret Tours, although that one's kind of on the large side, so if you didn't pick that one, I would be pretty happy. Vault 88, obviously, have not built that. Mechanist Lair, have not built that. But anyway, leave a note in the comments and let me know where would you like to see the 1,000 subscriber. I don't really want to build here, but I will because why the hell not? Special for the settlements and survival character, which means it will be unmodded, and it will be... I guess there won't be any settlers there for the most part, but if I have to make it a settlement, I will put settlers there and farms and what have you. So, are we getting, how are we doing here on time? We're at, 23 minutes? Okay, so now we're going to put a fence around the outside here. I'm trying to decide how I want to do this. Do I want to put that fence? Do I want to put this fence? But yeah, again, we're doing the varying heights, varying angles thing. Now at that little depression there, of course, I'm going to be putting a guard station. And after this, I guess we're not going to have too much to build. I mean, it's only going to be the greenhouse, which is going to be the bar slash lounge slash sunroom, I guess. I don't really know. I mean, I've got this thing where I'm going to have chaise lounges and like a center bar and plants and music. And I guess that's about it, right? Because the food's taken care of out here, and I need to build around this corner. And I'm like, do I want to build more walls? I don't want to build more junk fences. I'm going to put some plants over here. So yeah, we're gonna enclose this with plants. And that will be that. So, what else is going on? Future plans? I don't even know. Got to finish Greentop. But it's getting complete. I don't know if I really... I think I built too much here. I'm trying to get back away from the gigantic builds like Starlight. Because it's weird. It's like as I build, it's like I keep building more and more and more and more. It's like I get these huge monstrosities of settlements and I can't figure where the... I can't figure out where the rug is. Where the hell's the rug? Did I lose it? Where did I even put it? Oh, it's way over there. Wow, what the hell? So, after this, I may after Greentop, trying to think where I want to go next after this. I definitely want to save Finch because Finch is going to be the Abraham junk pile up from hell. He's gonna have the junk pile of his dreams. But I'll have to clear out the scrapyard nearby and examine the hell out of it to make sure I know what he can take and what he'll have. But I'm really thinking about Coastal Cottage a lot in terms of what it's going to be. And I really, really want to play with the mass of metal and, you know, the new retextured wood and metal walls and pieces and stuff. Because, I mean, that has so much potential for the type of building I do. And I'm like, oh, I want that so bad. But I got to figure out a way to use it. And I don't use it on Settlement Survival because she doesn't have mods. So, well, not Settlement Building mods. She's vanilla. And someone left a comment on the how she was doing and what perks had I taken. I should probably research these things before I start talking, but I guess that would take the fun out of it, right? They were asking, you know, how do I spec? What did I perk into? How do I whatever? So what I'm going to do is I basically did write them down after level 23. I wrote down every perk I took up to about level 90. So maybe at some future point I'll just have those scroll across the screen during a Settlements and Survival build or something, or I'll just reply to that person and just list them. But that's a lot of text, man. That's a lot of text. Yeah, I guess I should probably start talking about the future of the channel. I mean, 1,000, that's Jesus, 1,000 people, man. I mean, that's like a high school graduating class at a big high school. That's a lot of people. I try not to think about it because it kind of freaks me out to think, all right, so now we're done. Now we're going to go over the tour. And after too many hours that I'm not going to admit that it took me to do this, here's what it looks like furnished. I mean, you know, sort of trimmed up, completed. I did change my mind on the back of the house. It was just too much silver. Couldn't deal with it. So dressed my guards up, put a little patio out here with these things here. Let's jump over here. So here's the outside patio area with, you know, random haphazard railings and stuff like that. I figured, you know, they could find match furniture for this with enough scavenging. So this is kind of standard out here. Back here behind the house, I went ahead and gated this off because I did have a cow here. So I needed someplace to put him. So I gave him a water bin and some hay bales, and he never cooperates, but whatever. He stays back here. Sometimes his head sticks back to the wall. Changed the stuff here. Added some foundation stuff here to break up the monotony of that foundation. Got the short order window. In case I want to get snacks, I can just go to her. And come up here. Here's the finished kitchen area, such as it is. Here's the where you get your real food here from her. And, you know, stoves, fridges, enough working area to support, you know, feeding, I don't know, 15, 20 people, maybe 30 with this kind of setup. Not decorated, of course, but we'll deal with that later. And fluorescent lights everywhere just to make sure there's enough lighting. Figure I'll put cleaning supplies underneath the and that broken thing underneath here. So the first level, we've got the nice quarters for, I don't know who, tuck some crap under the stairs there, under that little alcove. And then up top, just, they get the crash up here. There's not a lot of stuff up here because they're working for a living. And that's what we've got for this phase. So now after this, I suppose we're going to be doing, we're going to be dressing out the inside of the greenhouse there, fixing those other two guards and seeing what we can do. Can I jump over this? Jeez, really? There we go. So we'll look at it from the back over here on the side. It's kind of boxy. I mean, the warehouse walls, you can't really do much with them, but you can make them look kind of funky with different angles. So that's something, right? So, okay. So this is it. This is done here. Next up, I guess I'm going to go back to Settlements and Survival and see what we're going to do with her. I want to thank you all very much for subscribing and watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.